GST, Goods and Service Tax. At present in our country, indirect tax play a very important role and contributes 50% of central executor and 70% of state executor. When the country is opting the new regime of taxation, GST, having characteristics like destination-based tax, free flow of credit even for interstate supply, less exemption and exclusion. Nowadays, the government expenditure on various welfare and infrastructure initiatives is at increasing rate. In order to realize the above objectives, collection of indirect taxes is essential. Internationally, the tax rate is any new regime is derived based on revenue neutral rates, RNR. Revenue neutral rate is a layman terms, is a rate that allows the central and state to sustain the current revenues from the tax collection. Meaning of goods and service tax: G for goods, S for service, T for tax. GST is consumption based tax. It is a tax levied on goods and services consumed. Goods and service tax will be levied on each point of sale and provision of services, which would be called taxable supply in GST regime, against the manufacturer's sale or provision of services. In other words, goods and service tax means a tax on supply of goods or services or both, except taxes on supply of alcoholic liquor for human consumption. GST is applicable to the whole India except Jammu and Kashmir. GST is a single comprehensive tax on the supply of goods and service, right from the manufacturer up to the final consumption of goods and services. It is a value addition on each stage, and credit of tax paid on earlier stage will be available on next stages as input tax credit, ITC. Input tax credit can be adjusted against output tax by a registered taxable person. Burden of the tax to be borne by the final consumer. GST means a tax on supply of goods or services or both. GST is a value-added tax levy on sale or services or both. GST is the destination-based consumption tax. GST offers comprehensive and continuous chain of tax credit. GST eliminates cascading of tax. GST brings uniform tax structure all over India. GST were burden borne by the final consumer. So, definition of goods and service tax. And as per Amendment Article 366, 12A of the Constitution of India, goods and service tax means any tax on supply of goods and services or both, except taxes on supply of alcoholic liquor for the human consumption. Origin of GST. History of GST in India. The concept of the GST was first introduced in France in the year 1954. History of GST in India. 2000. Idea of GST mooted during the period of Atal Bihari Vajpayee government, when it set up the Asim Das Gupta Finance Minister Government of West Bengal Committee to design model of GST in 2000. In 2004, the idea of national GST was introduced, mooted in India by Kelkar Committee in 2004. Dr. Vijay Kelkar recommended then the national GST. The first announcement for introduction of GST 28/6/2006 by the Finance Minister P. Chidambaram. It was proposed to introduce national-wide GST on 1/4/2010. This target date could not be achieved mainly due to the political difference. 1/4/2007, GST rates was reduced to 4% to 3%. On 1/6/2008, GST rate was further reduced to 3% to 2%. The first discussion paper was released by Empowered Committee. The proposed GST law is broadly on lines as indicated in the discussion paper on 10/11/2009. On 2011, the 115th Constitution Amendment Bill was introduced in Lok Sabha for levy of GST on all the goods and services other than some of the specified goods. But at that time, bill was not passed by the House. On 3/8/2016, 101 Constitutional Amendments 2014 was passed by Rajya Sabha. GST bill was introduced in Lok Sabha by Union Finance Minister Shri Arun Jaitley as Constitution. 122nd Amendment Bills 2014 on 19/12/2014, the same was renumbered as Constitution. 101st Amendment Bill by Rajya Sabha. GST was notified by the government and bill got presidential assent, and it was also ratified by 16 states. On 22/9/2016, first meeting of the GST Council was held. On 29/3/2017, Lok Sabha passed the following four bills relating to the GST, that is CGST, the Central GST Bill, IGST, the Integrated GST Bill, the GST Consumption Bill, and UTGST, the Union Territory GST Bill. On 6/4/2017, these bills are further passed by the Rajya Sabha to be an act passed by both the houses of the parliament. On 12 April 2017, the President of India gave his assent to all the above mentioned law on GST. On 1/7/2017, GST will be coming into effect from 1/7/2017. And next, need for introduction of GST in India or objectives of GST. So GST was first introduced in France in the year 1954. More than 140 countries have implemented the GST. Genesis of GST occurred during previous NDA government under Atal Bihari Vajpayee government, when it was set up in Asim Das Gupta committee to design a model for GST. The UPA government took the matter further and announced in 2006. Nowadays, all goods and service tax was spreaded quickly, and what has been described as an unparcelled tax phenomenon. This is the most important event in the evolution of the tax structure in the second half of the 20th century. Thus, due to its overwhelming popularity and its undeniable appeal in its pure form, GST has been applied around the world to the different degrees. So for 140 countries, GST has been implemented. The following needs or aims of GST: no cascading of taxes, reduced compliance cost, seamless flow of credit, less wastage of time and effort of the compliant, less wastage of time and effort of compliant, transparent and corruption free, few number taxes, supportive to compute at domestic and international market, buoyancy in tax collection both of for central and state, minimize the inflation, imperative in emerging economic environment. Indian economy is getting more and more globalized.